Hi, welcome to Mazmata Corporation. My name is Jamie Sokolsky, and I'm the General Sales Manager here, based out of Bristol, Wisconsin, in charge of U.S. operations. From time to time, we get asked a lot of different questions in regards to our product lines and what really sets Mazmata apart from the competition. Taking this into consideration, what we've decided to do is start showing you a little bit of a video series that's going to give you the build, different applications, and the quality that goes into a Mazmata product. But more importantly, our goal is to show you the value that Mazmata brings to you and your business, and really how you're going to benefit from making this choice. So if you wouldn't mind, please join us over here. What I've done is lay out all the different internal pieces it takes to build one of these 4000 PSI rated DGV live swivels. And what I'm going to do later on in the program is show you the true live performance under pressure that we offer. This being said, you can see from the internal build what sets us aside from the competition is we do 5 different internal style seals, 7 different machine components with a true thrust bearing that's going to be self-lubricating and give you that smooth operation under pressure. Part of the family on this series of DGV is going to be the DGK, which is very similar with a few different less build items. This one right here has a barb fitting so you can crimp your own hose on, whether it's air, hydraulic, other types of OEM application. Twist couplers, once you screw them in and lock them in place, you still have that live rotation on the back end as well. Along with the lineup we've started doing for air tools, we have a machine where you can put on your own fittings, or we've machined the fitting right onto the swivel itself. What we're going to do later on in the video is we're going to show you some true live application, along with some pressure testing from our product against the competition to show you the true value in a Mazmata gun swivel. However, what I briefly wanted to do is go over and explain to you just one of the scenarios that's most commonly asked or information is requested on. A high pressure hose is nothing more than a flexible pipe. Once you put this under pressure, even without pressure, it has zero twist capability. What does that mean? It means it's going to put stress on your hose crimps and the componentry on your gun triggers. Adding the swivel in here is not only going to save the wear and tear on that, but take away all of that wrist fatigue. That right there is going to be a great value for you and your application or your different operations that you're going to be performing. What I've done here is I've built a simple little pressure tree so that this way each unit's going to be tested at the same time, so there's no deviating or changing the performance level. Right now with zero pressure, I wanted to show you the difference between us and the competition to start off with. First off, we get asked a lot of times, why do I even need a live performance swivel or a swivel in general on the hose? Because I have a quick coupler. What I've done is I've got a gauge with the quick coupler on here. And just to give you an example, it takes a lot of force to create that rotation, even without pressure. What you'll see later on is once we add pressure to the tree, that's going to freeze up just as rigid as your hose with no twist or basically another section of piping. I'm taking a 14 millimeter wrench and I'm just going to set it up on here, set it a horizontal motion, let the wrench go, and you'll see the amount of friction it takes to cause this wrench to fall. As you see, this one's going to sit here without any weight. It's not moving. Moving up to another competitive unit, setting it horizontally, you'll see it has a slow fall, which means it has less friction on it at zero pressure. The next unit over here, a little bit smaller in build, has about the same speed of fall on it. So again, it's a little bit of a tighter unit. We'll move over to the Mazmata, again with the horizontal, no friction. You'll see that live performance is also going to move over when we throw it under pressure. And what I've also done is I've got a digital scale here, so I'm going to show you the different amount of force it's going to take to create the rotation while it's under pressure. All right, so we've come into the testing room and we're gonna set this up with pressure. We're gonna bring the pressure up to 2,000-3,000 PSI. And then I'm gonna just throw the wrench on there and show you the pressure gauge to get a little bit of a rotation out of there. So bear with me one moment while I get everything set up. All right, so what we'll do, let the pressure run up a little bit and then it's gonna drop down. And we'll start over here with the Mazmata swivel. We're gonna set this up on the wrench and then just kind of lift. So what I'm getting on a reading for rotation is 0.39 steady on a pull. I'm gonna move up to this one here And on a poll with this one, I'm at 0.90 on a steady gradual pull. I'm gonna pull the trigger because as you see, the pressure's dropping a little bit so I can bring it up to an even test. All right, so we're at about an even test parameters. And pulling up on this one, to get a steady pull, you're at 2.4, 2.3 to be safe. Moving up to the last one, steady pull, to get it moving is about 2.2. 2.4. And as people have mentioned in the past, why do I need one when I have a twist coupler? Just to give you an example here, this is under pressure. This is not twisting easily at all. I can throw a wrench on there and we can check the pressure to get it to twist. But again, a quick coupler is not meant to be a swivel. It's just a compression connection and the O-ring is what really seals it. And with pressure, it's just locked into place.
So pardon the noise, as you can see we're running about 2800 PSI. I cannot twist this gun. So let me walk out the hose and show you what your real life performance will be. Automatic gun swivel at 2800 PSI. Just to give you an example, this is with the Mosmatic gun swivel.
Well, we appreciate you taking the time to sit with us and kind of run through what is going to give you an advantage with the Mosmatic product. On this show, we wanted to go over the DGV line along with the family members of that, the DGK, DKS, and just kind of give you an overview of the value you're going to get and how it's going to work for you and your company. If you have any further questions or need more information, feel free to contact a Mosmatic registered dealer or Mosmatic directly. We look forward to your feedback and questions. Thank you.